What if Mars is actually the worst place to colonize? Everyone's obsessed with Mars, but here's what they're not telling you. Mars is basically a radioactive wasteland. The atmosphere is so thin, you'd get fried by cosmic rays in months. You'd literally have to live underground like a mole person. But Saturn's moon Titan, it has lakes of gasoline, literal rocket fuel just sitting there in oceans. The atmosphere is so thick you could strap on wings and fly around like a superhero. Sure, it's colder than liquid nitrogen, but at least you won't get slow cooked by radiation. Mars takes 9 months to reach. Titan takes 4 years. But Titan might be the only place in our solar system, besides Earth, where humans could actually build a civilization that lasts forever. Let's start by demolishing some Mars myths, because the marketing department for Mars colonization has been working overtime. Yes, Mars is closer. That 6 to 9 month journey sounds reasonable until you realize it's a one-way ticket to becoming a cosmic radiation sponge. Here's the brutal truth. Mars lost its magnetic field billions of years ago. Without that invisible shield, the planet is getting absolutely pummeled by deadly particles from space every single day. To put this in perspective, astronauts on the International Space Station, which is protected by Earth's magnetic field, still receive about 150 times more radiation than we do on the surface. Mars? Try 3 times more than that. We're talking about radiation levels that would give you cancer within months, not years. The solution everyone talks about is living underground. Imagine spending billions of dollars and risking your life to travel to another planet, only to become a cave dweller. You'd see sunlight about as often as a coal miner in the 1800s, and that famous Martian atmosphere everyone mentions. It's 100 times thinner than Earth's. To put that in perspective, it's like trying to breathe at an altitude of 100,000 feet. Even Mount Everest's summit has air that's practically thick by comparison. But wait, there's more bad news. Martian soil is loaded with toxic chemicals called perchlorates. These aren't just harmful to humans. They're so reactive that they can literally explode. Growing food in Martian soil would be like trying to garden in a chemistry lab's waste disposal. Now let's talk about Titan, which is probably laughing at our Mars obsession. First, let's address the elephant in the room, the cold. Titan is cold. We're talking negative 179 degrees Celsius, which is colder than anywhere on Earth has ever been. It's so cold that water becomes harder than granite, and the rocks on Titan's surface are actually made of frozen water ice. But remember how I mentioned lakes of gasoline? Titan has literal seas of liquid methane and ethane, hydrocarbons that we use as fuel here on Earth. The largest of these seas, Kraken Mare, is bigger than all of North America's Great Lakes combined. So instead of trying to manufacture fuel from scratch like we'd have to do on Mars, Titan is essentially a gas station the size of a small planet. We're talking about enough raw materials to power human civilization for thousands of years. But the real game changer is Titan's atmosphere. At one point, 5 times the pressure of Earth's atmosphere, it's thick enough to provide real protection from cosmic radiation. It's like having a natural spacesuit that covers the entire moon. And here's the mind-blowing part. This thick atmosphere, combined with Titan's low gravity, only 14% of Earth's, creates conditions where human-powered flight isn't just possible, it's almost effortless. You could literally attach wings to your arms and fly around like a bird. It's the closest thing to having superpowers that physics will allow. Let's talk about why Titan is an engineer's dream and Mars is an engineer's nightmare. On Mars, every piece of equipment has to be radiation hardened, which means heavier, more expensive, and more complex. Your solar panels degrade rapidly, your electronics fail, and your habitat needs to be buried under tons of regolith just to keep you alive. On Titan, the thick atmosphere means gentler landings. Remember how nail-bitingly terrifying Mars landings are? The 7 minutes of terror where everything has to work perfectly, or your multi-billion dollar mission becomes an expensive crater. On Titan, you could literally use parachutes for the entire descent. It's like trying to land a feather in a windstorm versus dropping it gently into a swimming pool. The construction possibilities are incredible too. That low gravity means you can build structures that would be impossible on Earth or Mars. We're talking about towers that could stretch dozens of kilometers into the sky, bridges that span entire continents, and habitats that float in the thick atmosphere like aerial cities. Energy production is another massive advantage. While Mars forces you to rely on increasingly inefficient solar panels or complex nuclear reactors, Titan offers multiple options. Wind power is incredibly effective in that thick atmosphere. You could possibly even tap into the flow of methane rivers and lakes. And if you want to go nuclear, you've got all the benefits without the radiation exposure problems you'd face on Mars. But here's where things get complicated, and honestly, a little scary. We have no idea what ultra-low gravity does to human biology over the long term. We know that astronauts lose bone density and muscle mass in zero gravity, but Titan's gravity is somewhere between 0G and Mars gravity. Would children born on Titan develop normally? Would they be able to visit Earth? Would they even want to? Or would Earth's gravity feel impossibly heavy to them? This isn't just academic curiosity. It's the fundamental question of whether we're talking about a human colony or the birthplace of a new human subspecies. Some scientists speculate that after just a few generations, Titan-born humans might be so adapted to their environment that they'd be effectively a different species. On the flip side, that same low gravity might offer advantages we haven't even considered. Medical procedures might become easier. Construction work would be less physically demanding. Even basic movement would become more efficient. We might be trading some unknowns for some incredible benefits. And then, those hydrocarbon lakes aren't just fuel. They're the raw materials for an entire industrial civilization. Methane and ethane can be converted into plastics, synthetic materials, and even food precursors. It's like having the entire petrochemical industry of Earth just sitting there, waiting to be harvested. Compare that to Mars, where every resource has to be extracted from rock, processed in complex facilities, and carefully rationed. On Titan, you've got rivers of the stuff flowing into seas larger than Earth's Mediterranean. But it gets better. Titan likely has a subsurface ocean of liquid water beneath its icy crust, potentially more water than all of Earth's oceans combined. So you've got fuel on the surface and water underground. It's like nature designed the perfect pit stop for interplanetary civilization. The nitrogen atmosphere is another huge advantage. Nitrogen is essential for life as we know it, and it's just hanging there in the air, free for the taking. On Mars, you'd have to extract nitrogen from the soil or import it from Earth at enormous cost. Here's what really separates the Mars dreamers from the Titan visionaries. We're not just talking about survival, we're talking about thriving. Mars colonies would be dependent on Earth. The radiation exposure, the resource limitations, the constant struggle against a hostile environment. It's survival mode, not civilization mode. Every generation would be fighting the same battles their parents fought. Titan offers something different, the possibility of true independence. With abundant energy, raw materials, and natural protection from radiation, a Titan colony could eventually become completely self-sufficient. We're talking about a world where humans don't just survive. They evolve, they innovate, they become something more than what we are on Earth. Some scientists have proposed that Titan could eventually be terraformed, not to be more like Earth, but to be optimized for the humans who live there. So, is colonizing Titan better than Mars? The answer depends on what you mean by better. If you want to plant a flag and say humans were here, Mars wins. It's closer, more familiar, and we could probably get there within the next 2 decades. Mars is humanity's first attempt at becoming a multi-planetary species. But if you're thinking about the long game, about where humanity goes to become a truly spacefaring civilization, Titan starts to look like the obvious choice. It's got the resources, the protection, and the potential for genuine independence that Mars simply cannot offer. The real truth might be that we need both. Mars is our training ground, our proof of concept, our first tentative step into the cosmos, and Titan is our destination, the place where we don't just survive in space, but make it our home. Here's what I want you to think about. Knowing everything you know now, would you rather be a pioneer on Mars, struggling against radiation and limited resources, or would you rather be an explorer on Titan, flying through hydrocarbon skies above seas of liquid fuel? Drop your thoughts in the comments. I read every single one. And if this video changed how you think about humanity's future in space, hit that like button and subscribe for more mind-bending science content.